Praise the Lord, everybody. Welcome to Sunday Afternoon Church with Purpose, right here in the Godly Mom's living room. And Godly Dad's sitting here with the guitar, gonna bless us with the beautiful playing while we sing. And I'm so thankful for this day. And we're gonna start here with, this is the day the Lord has made. Let's pray first. Precious Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this time. Lord, I just pray right now over the signal, over the airwaves in Jesus' mighty name. Lord, we cancel every plan of the enemy right now. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus, that your precious blood covers us. Father, I pray that you would lead everybody to this broadcast that needs us today. Lord, help us to be a blessing. We want to bless you. We want to bless the people. I thank you, Lord, for this precious time, and we give it to you. In Jesus' name, amen, amen. Ah, but everything has breath, praise the Lord. This is the day, amen.
Oh, this is the day. This is the day that the Lord hath made, that the Lord hath made. We will rejoice and be glad in it, and be glad in it. This is the day that the Lord hath made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day. This is the day that the Lord hath made. Oh, Jesus is the way. Jesus is the way that the Lord hath made. That the Lord hath made. We will rejoice. We will rejoice and be glad in Him. And be glad in Him. Jesus is the way that the Lord hath made. We will rejoice and be glad in Him. Jesus is the way. Jesus is the way that the Lord hath made. Oh, this is the day. This is the day that the Lord hath made. That the Lord hath made. We will rejoice, we will rejoice and be glad in it, and be glad in it. This is the day that the Lord hath made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day, this is the day that the Lord hath made.
In Psalms 9, verses 1 and 2, it says, I will praise you, O Lord, with my whole heart. I will tell of all your marvelous works. I will be glad and rejoice in you. I will sing praise to your name, O Most High. Hallelujah. And that's why I'm here today. Amen. We want to lift up the name of the Lord. Jesus is the name above all other names. There is no other name given under heaven by whereby men must be saved when they call on it. When you call on Jesus. Oh, that beautiful song, when I call on Jesus. Amen. Praise the Lord. We're going to sing victory in Jesus. I hope those of you that watch that you sing with us. Clap your hands and praise the Lord with us, because that's what we do. That is what gets you free. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
I heard an old, old story, how a Savior came from glory, how He gave His life on Calvary to save a wretch like me. I heard about his groaning, of his precious blood's atoning. Then I repented of my sin and won the victory. Oh, victory in Jesus, my Savior forever. Oh, he sought me and he bought me with his redeeming blood. He loved me ere I knew him, and all my love is to him. He plunged me to victory beneath the cleansing flood. Oh, I heard about his healing and his cleansing power revealing. How he made the lame to walk again, and he caused the blind to see. And then I cried, dear Jesus, come and heal my broken spirit. And somehow Jesus came and brought to me the victory. Oh, victory in Jesus, my Savior forever. Oh, he sought me and he bought me with his redeeming blood. He loved me ere I knew him, and all my love is to him. He plunged me to victory beneath the cleansing blood. Oh, I heard about a mansion he has built for me in glory. And I heard about the streets of gold beyond the crystal sea, about the angels singing and the old redemption story. And some sweet day I'm gonna sing up there the song of victory. Oh, victory in Jesus, my Savior forever. He sought me and he bought me with his redeeming blood. He loved me ere I knew him, and all my love is to him. He plunged me to victory beneath the cleansing flood. Oh, he plunged me to victory beneath the cleansing flood.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Welcome to all of those of you who are joining us. And I can't put my finger on there and scroll around and find you and talk to you. So you just be blessed. And I encourage you, share the video. I challenge you to be a witness today. You know, share this video. That's what we're here to do, is to worship the Lord together and share his love and to share the gospel. Be a witness. Share good things. If you come on Facebook, yeah, you might have a little fun. But I challenge you today, believers, share this video. Share this video. Amen, amen. Those of you, my sons and daughters out there, you share the video. Amen. As Mama shares your things to send out the gospel and the truth of what's going on in the kingdom of God. Amen, amen. Well, during this past week, we have experienced some loss that I know of that touches my heart deeply. And first, I want to send my love to Justin Givens and the Givens family and the Robarges. I love you all, and I am going to miss my dear sister Sue Givens so much. Trinity Gospel Temple family, we know what a treasure. If there was a passion play costume to be made, I bet Sue's stitches are in there somewhere. Faithful servant of the Lord, and I love that dear sister. And we'll see her in glory. Hallelujah. She's gone on to be with Jesus, and I miss her. But also in the body of Christ and in the United States, a patriot, a man of God. And a lot of us just thought of him as a country western star. And I'll tell you, Charlie Daniels loved God with all his heart and still does. Loves God with all his heart. And he's at the feet of Jesus today, passed away the other day, posted a scripture online that neither death nor life nor nothing could separate him from the love of God. And within minutes, he was in the presence of the Lord, a total shock and surprise. And we miss him, and our hearts go out to Sister Hazel Daniels and all the family and his band. Truly, the United States is blessed with a man who loved God and country. Amen. And did a lot for the kingdom of God and this nation. So I want to sing I'll Fly Away. I know that that's one that was one of Brother Daniel's favorites. And I know Sue loved that song too. And I want to sing it. I want us to know that we have the promise of heaven, body of Christ. And that day when he calls us home, whether it's leaving this body this way or when Jesus returns, we're gonna fly away. Hallelujah.
Well, some glad morning when this life is over, I'll fly away to a home on God's celestial shore. I'll fly away. Oh, I'll fly away. Oh, glory, I'll fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away. Now when the shadows of this life have grown, I'll fly away. Like a bird from prison bars has flown, I'll fly away. Oh, fly away, oh glory, I'll fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away. Now just a few more happy days and then I'll fly away to a land where the joy shall never end. I'll fly away. Oh, I'll fly away. Oh, glory, I'll fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away. Oh, hallelujah, by and by, I'm gonna fly away.
praise the Lord. Thank you, Lord, for that promise of heaven. Ooh, a lot of people get saved just for that fact. But there's so many other blessings, too, to serving the Lord. Well, as I get ready to preach the gospel here, and Brother Anthony puts his guitars away. Are you leaving, dear? He's going to leave to go across town and be with our other friends. Love you, Sean and Robin and John and Jeff. Mwah. I love you. I would come with you, but I'm busy. You know, this morning I was asking the Lord what to talk to the people about today. And I heard Papa Kenneth Copeland preaching from 1 John chapter 4, and I could not get away from that chapter. And thinking about the love of God, thinking about how things have been this year, thinking about the last few weeks, now it seems like it's calming down, and the flesh wants to wonder, oh, what big crazy thing are we going to have next? But I'm not going to think like that. The Bible says, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. Jesus was very aware of the things, being the Son of God, being the embodiment of the Word and the anointing. Hallelujah. He knew. He would tell the disciples, you know, I'm going to suffer like this. These things are going to happen. And a lot of people said, what you talking about, Jesus? And he would tell them in parables, and they'd, what you talking about, Jesus? So as a believer, I believe that the Holy Spirit, he's going to give us plenty of insight right ahead of us. I'm not going to worry. I'm not going to worry about nothing. Because Jesus is Lord to the glory of God the Father. And no matter what is happening, we have the presence of the Lord with us. And turn with me in your Bibles today to the book of 1 John. These are the epistles of John right before Jude and Revelation. So 1 John, not the Gospel of John, 1 John chapter 4. Amen. And we're going to pray over the reading of the word. See you later. Be safe. Godspeed in Jesus' name. We have a storm moving in, so stay between the lightning bolts, Peepaw. Let's pray over the reading of the word today. Precious Heavenly Father, thank you for your word. Thank you, Lord, that it is eternal. And that your word, oh, once you utter it, it goes forth and does precisely your will. So today, Lord, as I speak your word, I pray it go forth and do precisely what your will is. Oh, hallelujah. Let me be your instrument today, Lord. I humble myself before you, Lord, and I ask you to only let me say what you would have me say. Holy Spirit, be teacher and guide through me right now, I pray. Father, I pray for all of us, Lord. Give us ears to hear what you want us to hear. I pray, Lord, that our hearts, our spirit man, become fertile ground to receive the precious seed of the gospel today. That our minds can stay focused on the word and hear you clearly, Lord. Oh, hallelujah. Let that word become rooted and grounded, sprout and grow and bring forth fruit. Ooh, in every season, Lord. Fruit in every season, I pray, in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Amen and amen. Praise God. praise God. Welcome, Josh, Haroon. Love you, sons. And share the video. Let's get some people together and listen to the word. Turn with me to 1 John chapter 4. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And we're going to go to verse 11 as the high point, okay, of the chapter. But trust me, I'll be all over that chapter. My heart is full. Amen. 1 John chapter 4, verse 11. Beloved, if God so loved us, we also ought to love one another. Amen. This was written by John the Revelator. This John is the biological little brother of Jesus. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And when I read his writings, wow. You know, I've spoken on this before. Someone who grew up in the house, watching Big Brother. Watching Big Brother next to your daddy, but knowing there's something different about him. Watching him, just, I have to say this boldly about my Lord Jesus. He was very comfortable while growing up. He was comfortable in doing the will of the Father. He was comfortable being sin-free. Oh, my Jesus is comfortable and confident in his lordship. Hallelujah. You know, we always recognize little children that are behaving well. Little children that are, you know, that love Jesus truly and aren't out for a lot of mischief. And we, oh, you want to pat them and say, what a good boy, what a good girl. And, oh, I never have any problem with this child. But think about it. Mary could really say, that's a good boy. Mary is the mother that had the absolute right to say, that's a good boy. That's a good boy. Because good comes forth, the word good comes forth goodness, God, to be godlike. And I'm telling you, when we say God is good all the time, yes, he is. But Mary had the right to look at that child that she had miraculously in that stable that night with moo, meh, all around him. Star in the heaven that just was blowing people's minds. I'm not digressing. I have to say this. It's in my heart. And she could look at him and say, yeah, good boy. And sometimes, if that was me, I would have been winking at him and saying, you really are just a chip off the old block. You really are just like your dad. Because she knew that the word of God was spoken into her before she was ever married. And she miraculously had a child. God just miraculously placed his son there within her to grow in human form so God, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost would have that, well, sympathy, that compassion would be even more enhanced by God dwelling among us in his Son. Oh, hallelujah. So, yeah. Lord Jesus, you are that one. God became flesh and dwelt among us. The Word became flesh and dwelt among us. In this chapter, John is expounding on these things. And he's surrounding the word love and the love of God with these things. And these facts, these biblical facts, these heavenly facts from God Almighty are surrounded in his love. This chapter, I challenge you to study 1 John chapter 4. I remember when years ago, and I started teaching junior church with Contessa Kathy Strobel back in the day, and Ruthie Carpenter, and Sister Arva Stump at Trinity Gospel Temple. And they taught me a song, and I memorized 1 John 4:7-8. Beloved, let us love one another. For love is of God, and everyone who loves is born of God, and knoweth God. But he who loveth not, knoweth not God, for God is love. Beloved, let us love one another. 1 John 4:7-8. And we would sing it over and over. And the kids would have so much fun. We would have fun teaching and leading the worship. Sometimes I had puppets and you couldn't see me. And I was Lightning Tyrone, a crazy horse puppet, or another puppet. And I would be singing, Beloved, let us love one another. I was a crazy horse. But you know what? I challenge any of you who were my kids in junior church. You tell me if you remember that song because of those services and those precious worship times in King's Kids Castle, which was children's church, kids church, whatever you want to call it now, but the children's outreach. 1 John 4:7-8. And yes, And the title of this part of the scripture here says, Knowing God Through Love. The Apostle John is telling us here, if you aren't feeling that, if you can't really walk in love with one another, and you aren't, see, love is a verb, love is a noun, love is an adjective, God is love. He's my all in all. If you don't love one another, and I challenge you to study 1 Corinthians chapter 13, the love chapter, where the Apostle Paul expounds the 25 ingredients of love. God gave me a marvelous teaching out of that. Look through my videos and find the 25 ingredients of love. And I think it is due season to bring it back again. I do. If you don't love one another, how can you say God? Say that you love God. If you can see one another and all you feel is hatred and disdain for whatever reason, political views, racial, skin color, ideals, who's carrying worse sin than you, or who's carrying more sin in your opinion. And if you are busy judging and looking for their sins and playing Mr. Pharisee, your sin might be looked at as a bigger one in the eyes of the Father. Oh, Sister Leilani's got her steel-toed shoes on again. Stepping on toes. This is God's word. Hallelujah. He is instructing us in the beginning of this chapter to try the spirits and see if they be of God. And he tells us, I got to read some of this. I do. A lot of people are worried right now. Oh, is the president the Antichrist? Oh, is the king of that country the Antichrist? Oh, where's the Antichrist? Oh, let's go. We're on a witch hunt for the Antichrist. I hope my brother in Florida is watching. Brother, Timon, I'm dedicating this message to you. This scripture, the Apostle John, he's dealing with these things. He says, now, every spirit that does not confess, this is verse 3, that Jesus Christ has come in the flesh, and that person is not of God. If they're not confessing, if they say, well, you know, we believe he was a prophet, Oh, I guess he's a good historical figure. Oh, yeah, I know about that guy. My granny had a picture of a shepherd holding a lamb, said that was Jesus. But you're not confessing Jesus is real, and he really did come from the heavenlies and come and live on this planet, walk this earth, doing the work of the Father that sent him. He says, if you don't confess, then you're not of God. Then that spirit is not of God. There are only two ruling spirits. What he's talking about is ideals, thought patterns, opinions, there's only going to be two ways, okay? Now, there is a way that seems right in the to man, but in the end there is death and destruction. So, you know, that way, the broad path that leads to destruction. And on that broad path is a lot of people who are deceived and saying, oh, you know, I don't go to church. I'm not churchy. Oh, don't talk to me about your Jesus. You know, I don't know about all that. You're on a wide path to destruction, my friend. And this is the spirit of Antichrist. Everybody's looking for it. The Apostle John said 2,000 years ago, now listen to me. He said, and this is the spirit of the Antichrist, which you have heard was coming and now is already in the world. See, the spirit of it, the enemy, that's Satan's realm, okay? Satan is the one who is the liar. He is the king of lies, the father of lies. And he is the one placing thoughts, thought patterns, ways of thinking, false religion. He is the one preaching the bad news. Jesus is not Lord. Don't you believe that? Satan is the one who is the spirit of Antichrist. Christ means the Redeemer. Yes, Christ means God with us, Emmanuel. Christ, Yesu Christu, Yesu Messiah, Messiah, Redeemer. Sent one, anointed one, and his anointing. Hallelujah. But anti that, against. Who's been against God from the start? Even when Lucifer was still a praise and worship leader in heaven, he was first created as an archangel with music built into himself. But he got cocky and prideful.
Oh, they're all coming to hear me sing. They aren't coming to worship God. I get to be up by the throne, but I think I'm singing better. I think I'm brighter. And somehow that idiot angel had the audacity to get a group of angels believing with him that he was going to take over heaven. See, the Bible says he exalted himself above God. He couldn't do that. There is none above God Almighty. Jesus says there's no one above the Father. He says not even he is above the Father. But the God the Father has appointed Christ Jesus as King and King of Lord, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Hallelujah. But the spirit of Antichrist, if John the Apostle said, the spirit of Antichrist, which you heard was coming, he said, people of God, you heard all the prophecies that Daniel in the Old Testament, even Jesus prophesied, there would. The spirit of that has been alive in this earth. Don't go on a witch hunt for the Antichrist. Don't go on a witch hunt. Oh, pointing to this president, not president. Do you know that all my life, I'm not going to tell you my age. I am past 30. I am a meemaw waiting on my eighth grandbaby to be born. And I'm going to tell you that in my life and the few presidents that I've seen in this United States, I have heard at some point that every one of them probably was the Antichrist. Thank you, Brother Dave Lombardi, my precious pastor in my whole life, my papa in the Lord. He brought forth the truth, and we will have this teaching another day, and I can't remember what book it's in the scriptures. It is very plainly proclaimed that the Antichrist, he rises out of Syria. We ain't never had a Syrian president in the United States. Right, brother? My brother, big brother Tim in Florida. Jesus people, brother. Amen. I love you. Says it's now, it's already in the world. See, that spirit was already in the world. That's the spirit that made the same people that ate bread and fish on the mountain side with Jesus to yell, "Crucify him and give us Barabbas." They were too scared of the Roman Empire and the Pharisees. And crucify him. They didn't want to be in that small group that said, no, Jesus is innocent. Jesus is Lord. He is the Messiah. They didn't want to be in there. And that spirit has been alive in the earth since that ugly devil got cocky with God and got himself thrown out of heaven. And Jesus said, "I saw Satan fall like lightning." Ooh, hallelujah. Devil, you get behind me. When the devil tempted Jesus in the wilderness, I remember before I left for Pakistan the first time, the Lord spoke to me clearly and said, "Daughter, I want you to meditate on how Jesus dealt with the devil in the wilderness." He said, "You shall not tempt the Lord your God." Ooh! The devil was up there trying to tempt Jesus. Jesus declared his lordship already and said, "Devil, you don't tempt me. You don't tempt me or the Father." Hallelujah. The spirit of Antichrist has been in the world a long time. Don't go on a witch hunt. Verse 4, John says to us, "You are of God, little children, and you have overcome them." And that's all those ones that are bound by the spirit of Antichrist that want to go through this earth declaring that Jesus is not Lord. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of them. They don't bother me. Hallelujah. Victory in Jesus. Like we just sang. It says, "You have overcome them because he who is in you is greater than he who is in the world." Woo! Greater is he that is in me. Greater is he that is in me. Greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. Oh, hallelujah. In verse 5, he says, "They are of the world and the world system. Therefore, they speak as of the world and the world system. And the world system hears them." A lot of people are speculating right now. I'm going to give you a piece of advice. Don't watch the news. Check the news. If you want to check the virus numbers in your state and make it a matter of prayer and pray in the name of Jesus, I pray for all 1,122 people or whatever to be healed and whole right now in the name of Jesus, fine. But don't dwell in the news. Don't read every meme that somebody makes up. And if you see even a brother or sister in Christ posting memes with cuss words and words of hatred, cursing the president, using foul language, that's not God. I don't care if you don't like the president. The Bible says you got to pray for your leader. Perhaps if you pray for him, he'll start being more likable to you. Or maybe your heart will be softened and you'll realize what's wrong in you and you won't have so much hatred. Oh, come on. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. I don't care what nation you're living in. Don't be spewing hate words at your leaders. No. Even if your government is one that is persecuting the body of Christ. The Bible says that you are to pray in the name of Jesus for the leaders and the kings and the queens of this world, that God would be the one that turned their head and turned their eyes. In Jesus' name, pray for the divine leadership of God and the convicting power of the Holy Ghost to be upon the kings and presidents, prime ministers and queens, tribal leaders of this land and of this world. Pray, pray. They are of the world and therefore they speak as of the world. If you claim Christ and you're speaking in agreement with the haters, you're speaking in the agreement with the Antifas and the gangsters and the ISIS, all the big gang terrorists of this world, whoever they are, self-appointed gods. They don't rule this world. No, they're twerking for their father, the devil. And yes, he has a little authority where he's allowed on this earth. But my Bible says that he goes about, and this is Jesus' words, that he goes about like a roaring lion. Rawr! What does the lion do? Rawr! He wants to scare you first, right? A big old lion. And I love lions. I love animals. And the day is coming where they won't be having the curse upon them. And they won't have to be in fear and then put terror on somebody else. Do you know that that's what does it? That's what causes a terrorist to terrorize. Somebody's already bound by fear. Somebody else is breathing down their neck. They're speaking like the world, seeing like their father, the devil. And if you haven't received Jesus as Lord, then I'm sorry, you're working for your father, the devil. God is my father. People say, oh, God is our father. Every person is a child of God. Every person is a beloved creation of God. And you are his favorite creation. But if you have not received Christ as Savior and Lord of your life, the Bible clearly says that you are not grafted in. You are not adopted in like the son and daughter of God. Honey, I'm sorry. Somebody told you wrong. You're a beloved creation of God. And in John 3:16, Jesus clearly said, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whoever, all of you, would believe on him should not perish. You won't have spiritual death. You won't, but you'll have everlasting life. There is no other way. Jesus said, if I be lifted up, I will draw all men unto myself. Lift Jesus higher. Lift Jesus higher. Lift him up so the world will see. He said, if I be lifted up from the earth, I will draw all men unto me. Amen. We are of God. Little children, you are of God. He who knows God hears us. Now I come to you in the name of Jesus today, and I am sent by God Almighty. I'm not nervous a bit to say that. I'm proud that my employer, sits on the grand throne of heaven. I'm so humbled that God would call me to preach the gospel. I'm so humbled that he would call me. As a baby, he called me. I heard his voice He called me to prophesy, to sing forth the praises of Him who called me out of darkness into His glorious light. Hallelujah! He who knows God hears us. If you're really hearing me today, you know the Lord. You know the Lord. He who is not of God does not hear us. You won't hear. As I always pray, God, give us ears to hear. And you know, Jesus said there were people, their hearts were hardened. And they had ears to hear, yet they did not hear. They had eyes to see, yet they did not see. This speaks of spiritual blindness and deafness. And sometimes Satan will bring that up in a heart of rebellion. The ones who are in the world and who are of the world. See, I'm not of this world. But yeah, weren't you born here? Yeah, I was born here. But I was born again here. Woo! Through the blood of Jesus. And I'm an ambassador from heaven. I work for the Lord God Almighty. Hallelujah. And every one of you, cleansed by the blood of the Lamb, who has made Jesus Christ your Lord and Savior. Hallelujah. You are born of God. And no more are you of this earth. You are a citizen of heaven, no matter what your birth certificate says. Okay, born such and such day on such and such town. Maybe you were born in a backseat of a car on a county line, and they weren't sure what to write on your birth certificate. But he who is not of God does not hear us. So if you're shutting me off today, there's that crazy woman from Ohio preaching about Jesus again. Ah, she's nice, but I don't want to hear her. You're not turning me off. You're not turning me off today. You're turning off the Word of God Almighty. You're turning off the Lord Jesus Christ. I'm here in His name. Angels of God are right here present with me. The anointing is in me and upon me and going right through this camera today. Hallelujah. He who is not of God does not hear us. And by this we'll know the spirit of truth and the spirit of error. If you're not following Jesus, I mean being serious about serving God. That doesn't mean we're perfect yet. But you accept His grace and His mercy. And you understand that He is perfecting you. And day by day, you're getting better. He's taking you from glory to glory to glory. The first day you're hired on a job, you aren't hired as president of the corporation. The first day you're hired on the job, you might be sweeping the floor downstairs in the mail room. It's the truth. Any good employer is going to train you first and see what he can trust you with. Even if all your credentials say, yes, this person is so-and-so and has a degree and has a doctorate, they still train you in their corporation, in their company. They still train you. Yeah, because you're working for them now. So, are you of the spirit of truth today? Or are you of the spirit of error? Mistake. Oops! See, error is the opposite of truth. Are you the spirit of lies? Have you foolishly followed lies? Examine your hearts today, dear ones. If you've never pray to the living God. I challenge you to pray to the living God, Yahweh, Jehovah God, the only true and living God. There is no other. Oh, people may carve a tree. People may worship a man who has been dead thousands of years or hundreds of years. A man who said, I think I'll invent a religion because I'm mad at the real God. I want to rise myself up just like my father the devil did in heaven.
But if they had any kind of brain, they would know that those who try to exalt themselves above God and exalt themselves above the Lord Jesus Christ, that there is certainly a fall coming. There is certainly a fall coming for the spirit of error in this earth. In Jesus' name, I speak the truth. Greater is the love inside you than the selfishness of the world. Greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. Greater is the spirit of truth within you than he that is in the world in error and mistake and sin. Most people sin in error. Somehow they either don't know, they're ignorant, have never heard of the Lord yet, and I'm sure there are few because we're reaching them, or you're rebellious, or something made you angry. But if you look at every source that would cause someone to slip and fall, and just momentarily, which we all can, if you look at the source, it'll be that spirit of error. Somehow, just as Eve was beguiled for a moment when that ugly old snakey said, "Shh, it's okay, Eve." God didn't really mean what he said. "Come up here and eat this with me." That's the spirit of Antichrist in the earth. It's a stinking devil. Amen. I hope somebody's listening to me. Type amen if somebody's out there. Hallelujah. We know the spirit of truth and the spirit of error because the spirit of truth is driven by the love of God. Love is our evidence. Love and faith. The Bible says that these three things remain. After the fruit of the Spirit, so these three, the end of Corinthians 13, the love chapter, these three things are going to remain: faith, hope, and love. Okay, the Bible says that faith worketh by love. Yeah. Faith works by love. So when you pray for Sister Leilani, I can feel the ones that are love-driven, faith-filled prayer. Prayed in sincerity to God the Father in the name of Jesus. Woo! Through the power of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God. And everyone who loves is born of God. See, you've been born again. Jesus said, you must be born again, enter into the kingdom of God. Yes, that means to go to heaven. That also means to enter into this kingdom life. This kingdom of God, it's a far step above serving the devil. Let me tell you that right now. There are perks to serving the Lord Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. Everyone who loves, if you have real love, and don't talk to me about all this nonsense right now. Love matters. Oh, yeah. There's real love, and then there's the fake stuff that isn't from God. And this is driven by lust and the spirit of Antichrist and the spirit of error. In this world, it's the same devil that drove the people of Sodom and Gomorrah. Don't be fooled by it. I'm going to be real bold. Jesus loves each and every one of you. But if you are deceived right now and you say, "Oh, love is love, you know, love is love no matter what." Oh, no matter what? I saw an article the other day. In another nation, someone's made, and a group of people driven by demonic lust are trying to get laws passed to marry their animals and to be in lust and sickening behavior with the animals. Don't you realize that was the stuff going on in ancient Egypt? These are paganistic things. These are demonic behaviors. God did not create us that way. Don't you be deceived. God is not mocked. Whatever you sow, you will reap. Don't be deceived. God is talking to us about the love that comes from Him. And yes, He has created a beautiful love. A beautiful love, because He created marriage. He created the home family unit. That's the first congregation. That's the first church. And God put His rainbow of promise over a family that was declared righteous. And it wasn't Noah's fault. I don't think it was Noah's fault. And it wasn't God's will that Noah's daughters went haywire and things went wrong and they began to walk in the curse again. After the flood was down and the ark had landed, that wasn't God's will. So don't you try to tell me that anywhere in this Bible, which is truth, and things kept forth for our learning, for the prophetic picture that it would give us. Don't you try to convince me that these things are not sin. Things that are driven by lust and demonic influence. Don't you insult my Heavenly Father's precious rainbow by using it to decorate sin. No. Come to Jesus. He loves you. Come to Jesus and repent. To repent doesn't just mean to say, oh God, forgive me, or read out a little prayer book, Father, forgive us, and chant over some beads. Okay, I don't care, Catholics, I don't care. You can pray on them beads all you want. Them beads ain't gonna do nothing. Other religions got beads, and those beads ain't doing nothing. Beads are just jewelry. I'm going to tell you right now, you call on Jesus, repent. That means to turn away. When the Holy Spirit convicts your heart and shows you that you have not been following the Spirit of truth, that you've been following the spirit of Antichrist, the spirit of error, the spirit of mistake, the spirit, the father of lies, sin in the earth. What, realize it and turn away. And ask God every day for His grace. Whatever that is in your life, whatever addiction, weakness, whatever it is, we all have stuff, you know. But give it all, give it all. Give it all to Jesus. Shattered dreams, wounded hearts, broken toys. Give it all, give it all. Give it all to Jesus. And He, only He, will turn your sorrow into joy. Only He. Only He. If you do not love your neighbor as yourself, then you don't know God. God is love. And don't you abuse this scripture to excuse having relations with animals, having same gender marriages. Don't you excuse those sins.
The Bible says those are abominations. Don't excuse that with this scripture. That's mockery. That's an abomination. Don't do it. If you have sin in your life, you don't have to confess your fault to any person. You don't have to come to me. If sometimes people come to me and say, I got an issue in my life, please pray. And I can pray delivering prayer, and we've seen people set free. And I will never tell on anybody. But I don't even have to know. Your priests don't have to know. But the priest of heaven, the high priest of heaven, you need to go to Jesus. You get in your prayer closet and you pray. And you confess those faults to Jesus today. Confess it to God. You know, He already forgave you on that cross. He paid for it. It's paid for. You don't have to be in bondage anymore. You don't have to be a slave to sin. Whatever the problems are, those chains that seem to bind you, I'm here to bring the anointing to you today. And the anointing breaks every yoke of bondage. The anointing breaks every chain. Love breaks the chains. Walk in the real love of God. And don't abuse His grace. Don't you spit on the cross. Don't you spit on the grace of God. It's like spitting in God's face, saying, I'll call myself a Christian, but I know you have grace, and I know you forgave me, so I'm going to do any doggone thing I want, and I know that I'm going to heaven. No. No. There's a fine line there, people, and we need to realize it today. Don't you hang on to sin and have that be your comfort zone. Don't hang on to the things. The Bible said, Jesus said that the backslider is like how when a dog goes back and eats his puke, eats his vomit off the ground. I'm like, God, why did you have that happen? But there's something in the nature of dogs that they recycle what they throw up. But the Bible says when you backslide, when you come to Jesus and then you decide to hang on to the comfort zone that the enemy had you trapped in, you don't want to leave that. You don't want to leave the whatever the works of the flesh are listed in Galatians, you know. Whatever the addiction is, whatever the weird behaviors and weird passions that your flesh has fallen into, because of the spirit of Antichrist in the world, it's nothing but the devil. If you want to hang on to that as your comfort zone, then you can't love. The Bible says you're like a dog says, oh no, I threw that up. And what is the real purpose of vomiting? Okay, science lesson with the godly mom. The vomiting reflex is your body saying, uh-oh, there's poison in me, I must eject it quickly. That's what vomit is. And ladies and gentlemen, if you're so afraid you're going to gain weight and you're putting your hand down your throat, it's still from the devil. You're turning on a reflex that is a God-given thing to throw poison and germs out of your body and things that could kill you. So you need to puke that up mentally right now in Jesus' name. And I pray right now for that spirit of self-destruction right now to be removed off of those anorexics and bulimic people right now that make yourself puke for whatever reason. In Jesus' name. I break the power of the enemy over you right now, and I declare freedom in your mind and your spirit, that demonic hold be broken right now in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. If we went back and we said, oh no, I lost my dinner. I really liked that. And yet you're sick, you're burning up with fever, and you went and you ate your own throw up? Come on. That, no way, man. No way. Jesus said clearly, if you run right back and you refuse to get out of the devil's grip and you begin to call that your comfort zone, it's like you're eating your puke over and over again. Come on, people, that's horrible. And God says, no, God didn't make us for that purpose. No. There have been times in my life where I'm like, oh, Lord Jesus, I'm so thankful for your grace. Oh, I didn't mean to slip back into that habit, whatever it was, way of thinking, way of speaking, whatever. Lord, I receive the fact that you made me your righteousness through Jesus. See, we are now the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. He's put his robe of righteousness on you. Righteousness means God's way of doing and being right. And honey, God didn't make you to eat your puke. God didn't make you to eat vomit. In Jesus' name, stop it right now. Turn. The Bible says, turn from your wicked ways. If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and turn from their wicked ways, and I will hear from heaven. I will redeem my people. I will heal your land. America, one nation under God, turn. Turn. Turn to Jesus today. Pakistan, turn to Jesus today. India, turn to Jesus today. Indonesia, turn to Jesus today. Canada, Japan, China, Turkey. Oh, in Jesus' name, turn. Come to your Redeemer today. Antarctica. Whoever you are there in Antarctica that will turn this on, and I know the Holy Spirit is showing me, it's probably going to be a scientist in a laboratory. I don't know who you are, Dr. So-and-so. They're in Antarctica studying. You're going to hear this, and you're going to hear the godly mom tell you, turn to Jesus. If you'll turn to Jesus and be a witness for him, and be unafraid to start prayer meetings in those science labs, God is going to allow you to discover something new that you never saw before. This is the word of the Lord. You scientists in Antarctica, listen to me today. God says if you will be bold enough, there, I think there's a born-again believer on that station, that science station at the South Pole. Whoever you are, you're going to listen to me on some venue. You're going to hear me. And this is the word of the Lord. If you will be bold enough to begin prayer meeting and Bible study, there's going to be a revival breakout at the South Pole. I declare it under the unction of the Holy Ghost, according to the word of God. I'm obeying my Lord. And you're going to see a discovery. God's going to give you a new discovery in Jesus' name. And it's going to benefit this planet. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Receive it in Jesus' name right now. Verse 9. In this, the love of God was manifested toward us, that God has sent his only begotten Son into the world that we might live through him. I heard a preacher say, you ain't living if you ain't living in Jesus. And I'm going to say amen. You ain't living. You aren't really living until you serve the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In this is love. Not that we loved God, but that he loved us. And he sent his Son to be the propitiation for our sins.
Jesus paid the ultimate price. But anyone and all of us in God's favorite creation, we're the only ones. Yes, all of creation bears a little bit of his image. But I am telling you today that we are created in the image of God. My picture of God the Father is one of a mighty champion. Is one of a mighty loving champion. Almighty. Sitting on the throne of heaven. King of all the ages. Hallelujah. That's what I see when I picture my Heavenly Father. And Jesus has come to me in a vision a couple times. And to me, he's beautiful beyond measure. And he came to pay that price today. He came. Beloved, if God so loved us, ought we not love one another? Shouldn't we love one another? It's not love when you hear a speculation or you hear a hate-filled speech and you say, oh, I better share that with everybody right away. Pass this on before it gets taken down. Some of that might be true. Pass this on right away. Stop it. Bring the word. I said this before. If I came on there and said, share this quickly before it gets taken down. Oh, Facebook doesn't like this. Instagram doesn't like this. Twitter doesn't like this. Oh, the left wing doesn't like this. Hurry up, put it up. Oh, here's some truth about President so-and-so, or here's some truth about Mr. Movie Star. I bet you I get so many likes and so many shares, it make my little cute head spin. But when I post a verse from the Bible, nobody shares it. I don't care. But here's what hurts my heart. When I share the word of the living God, and I share it, it doesn't have to have a pretty picture even. Yeah, that's a nice way. I like doing that. But not even using the little colored little blocks. Just putting the word out there. The word, Jesus. Jesus said, if I be lifted up, I'll draw men unto myself. See, I don't need all men to be drawn to me. I don't need the whole world. But when I put Jesus, even so-called powerful evangelists, oh, they love me so much, but they won't share when I post the simple word of God. Yet they want me to be their fan club because somehow I'm going to make them famous. Nah. If you lift Jesus up, he's going to give you crowns of righteousness that you can throw at his feet someday. You don't need Sister Leilani to make you famous. You don't need Brother So-and-so. Oh, Benny Hinn liked my comment. I don't know if Benny has got enough time to read all the thousands of comments that come. Probably Sister Hinn or secretary. That doesn't mean anything. People got really excited, and one of my spiritual moms, Marilyn Hickey, I'm going to tag you. I want you to hear this, Mama Marilyn. A lot of people that love you, Sister Marilyn Hickey, when they saw that you allowed a picture to be taken with me when you were here in October, and a lot of people wanted to get close to me because I know Marilyn Hickey. And I'm glad I do. She's one of my mamas in the Lord. And I'm glad I know Brother Dave and Marilyn Lombardi. And I'm glad that I know Nancy Harmon. And I'm glad I know a lot of wonderful men and women of God. And I've hugged their necks, shook their hands. But that's not going to make... That doesn't give me points. And it doesn't give you points if you know me, or if you know me because I know somebody else. You know what's going to give you some points? The only kind of points you need are those crowns of righteousness and the rewards that will come at the great judgment day. If you get wood, hay, and stubble, those rewards burn. But if he's going to give you rewards of crowns, then you have something beautiful to give Jesus. That's the only points I want. Yeah. So I want you to examine your hearts today. We must examine our hearts today. We got to. It's not about getting points. It's not about the left or the right. Jesus said, whoa, listen to this scripture. Look not to the left nor the right. Keep your eyes on Jesus. See, when Peter was walking on the water, he started, oh no, oh, that wave looks big. Oh, look at the stuff blowing over there. Oh. Jesus is saying, look at me. No, only look at me. And whoa, there he went down in the waves, and miraculously Jesus was right there and took his hand, and they walked on the water back together. Such mercy. Don't look at the waves. Look not to the right, not to the left, but look straight ahead. People talk about tunnel vision. That just means that someone is very focused. And our focus today needs to be the Word of the living God, Jesus Christ, the Word manifested in the flesh. And we need to love one another as He loves us. Not, Jesus said, He said, how easy is it to say, oh, I love you, you are nice to me. That lady at the grocery store was so nice to me. I just love her for that. But you might forget it in 5 minutes. Next time you see her, if she's in a bad attitude because maybe her child is sick at home and you go through that checkout line. Thank you very much. Ching, ching, ching. Yeah. Have a nice day. And she says, yeah, thank you. Okay. And she's maybe got her sick child on her mind. You walk out, well, check out girl Susie. Oh, she didn't compliment my hair today. She didn't chitty chat with me today. Huh? What, you don't love her anymore? You don't love check out girl Susie anymore? You don't know. She got a sick baby at home. And she's got 5 more hours on her feet that hurt because she didn't sleep last night with that sick baby. Now, come on, I'm speaking scenarios that are very, very probable. You don't know. Beloved, let us love one another. Jesus said, love each other the way I have loved you. Wow. Go the extra mile. And sometimes you love your friend enough not to agree with them when you see them acting in the spirit of error. They might say, well, why didn't you comment on my post? Well, what? Why didn't you share my video? If I'm asked that and I've seen, I'll say, you know, I'm praying for you. I'm praying for you, and maybe the Lord will lead me to give them a Bible scripture, and I'll leave it. I'll walk away from that
and I'll keep praying for them. And sometimes love, you know, that's the love of God and His mercy, that when we're ranting and raving and flailing in our rebellion and spirit of error, and we won't, and we're rejecting His help. Holy Spirit is a gentleman. God is a gentleman. Hands off. Do you ever try to hold a screaming child who's having the worst tantrum of their life and they can't gain control of their self yet? And no, beating the snot out of them isn't going to work. That's going to make them angrier. There's times when maybe a little smack on the butt and you sit them down. You have to, hands off. Okay, little lady. Okay, little man. You lay there and cry for a while, and you're not going to change mother's mind. You're not going to change daddy's mind, and you've got to stand back and pray. Keep an eye on them in case they roll around the floor and bump their head on something. Keep an eye on them. Make sure they're safe. Fix their dinner. But I promise you, that child will stop the crying. Okay, little one, what do you have to say for yourself? You know, and if in my children, my grandchildren, I'm sorry, yeah. And God has to stand back. And then we come to that point where we say, Lord, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Thank you for forgiving me. Thank you for your mercy. Thank you for not answering that prayer and letting me have that thing because it would hurt me. He loves us. Oh, how He loves us. Oh, how He loves. How He loves us. Study 1 John chapter 4. Will you do that for me? Will you study the Word this week, every day? Get in the Word. Feed your spirit. And if God loved us, shouldn't we be loving one another? No, not lusting after one another. Not whatever all this stuff is that we're being inundated. Not hero worship. That's not love. Mm-mm. I honor and respect mentors in my life. And they hold a special place in my heart. But I can't do hero worship. And you know that famous people that follow me online and communicate with me came to me. I didn't go to them. They came to me. I don't treat them like famous people. There's no stars except those beautiful bodies of light in the heavens. No, I don't. I don't care how many movies you made, how much I appreciate your art and your craft. I appreciate Tom Hanks' talent, okay? And other actors, but he's not a star to me. No, I sent him a text and told him I was praying for him to be healed in the mighty name of Jesus. I don't know if he read it, but it's out there. No one has seen God at any time, but if we love one another, God is abiding in us, and His love has been perfected in us. Amen. And by this, we know that we abide in Him. We are living in God Himself, and that He is living in us Himself, because He has given us of His Spirit. I'm thankful. You know you'll know and recognize your Heavenly Father and His presence in you, and the presence of Jesus, and the presence of the precious Holy Spirit. Yeah. When I say, I love you, I mean that. God has put this amazing, it's from the Spirit of God to the body of Christ, really to the whole world. And it's that love when I'm in Pakistan and we go out in the desert and hold them little dirty babies that don't have what they need. I love them. And I challenge you, help me help them. And pray for me. Pray for me that I may be able and equipped more and more as God is equipping me in this ministry to do more. Pray for me. Help me. Help me do that. Most of all, obey God. Give and share His love and be kind one to another. Tenderhearted. Okay? And let the words of our mouth and the meditation of our lips be pleasing unto the Lord. Cursing your president isn't. That's not God's love language. That's a big term right now. Love language. I just read you some of God's love language. Let's pray. Precious Heavenly Father, Lord, I thank you and I praise you. Oh, thank you for loving us. Thank you for loving me. Thank you for calling me. And I pray for each and every one at the sound of my voice now and until Jesus returns and after the rapture, as long as you allow this to play. In Jesus' name, I pray for your healing out there, for your deliverance in Jesus' name. I plead the blood of Jesus over the children of God right now. I thank you, Father, for divine protection on the body of Christ in every way. And I declare that these plagues, viruses are dead in the heavenlies already. The blood of Jesus covers your children, Lord. And I declare healing to all those right now who have suffered. Thank you, Father, for the victory that is in Jesus Christ, our Lord. Thank you for your love. Thank you, Lord. And I pray, meet every need out there. Whatever it is, meet every need. Thank you for your hand of mercy today. And I pray, Lord, for frontliners and the ones who are being bold and coming forth with the truth. Lord, I pray for them. And Lord, I pray for every plan of Satan to be canceled in Jesus' mighty name. Every lie to be defeated and brought low in Jesus' name right now. In Jesus' name, let truth prevail concerning any sickness, concerning anything. Keep our minds, Lord. I pray for the minds of believers. Oh, hallelujah. In the name of Jesus, touch. Set them free, Lord. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I praise you, Lord. I thank you for this time. I give you praise. And it's in Jesus' name. Everybody said, amen, amen. To the glory of God the Father. The Lord bless you and keep you.
make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. Amen. Shalom. Nothing missing, nothing broken. Thank you so much for joining me today as we worship the Lord together in both meetings. Thank you so much. And I praise the Lord for each and every one of you. And I thank you, all of you who support Purpose Ministries International and our partners. God bless you. God bless you. We love you. Jesus loves you, and Jesus is Lord to the glory of God the Father. Amen. You know I'm going to say it. I dare you. Be shining. Come back.